अबाउट दिस होल डिग्री एंड नॉन डिग्री थिंग, दिस एंटायर वेव स्टार्टेड आउट एंड आई लाइक टू यू नो टेक नेम्स एंड टॉक ओवर हियर अबाउट वरुण मायास एवलॉन आर्मी. सो द डे एवलॉन मेटा ऐप वॉज लॉन्च्ड एंड इवन प्रायर टू दैट ऑन हिज टेलीग्राम ग्रुप दिस एंटायर बज वॉज क्रिएटेड अबाउट हे यू नो वी आर द वंस हू अबेंडन कॉलेज एंड वी विल जस्ट लर्न स्किल्स ऑन आर ओन एंड वील ब्रेक द मार्केट एंड वट एवर. आई वॉज अ पार्ट ऑफ द टेलीग्राम ग्रुप ऑलमोस्ट लाइक फ्रॉम वेन इट वॉज क्रिएटेड. डाउनलोडेड मेटा नॉट जस्ट ऑन द डे इट वॉज लॉन्च बट ऑन द टाइम इट वॉज लॉन्च. It was. It came on Google Play. It gave. It came on Google Play Store at 9:15 a.m. I almost downloaded and started using the app from the exact time. That much, I respect Varun for the work that he's doing, and I have seen his live streams on YouTube. The favorite one was probably an hour of his stream, and to me, Varun Maya seems like a visionary person. Like I compare him to the Elon Musk of India, because like the people think that oh, he's the person who runs this company that does sales of these courses and all. No one has got clue that he has a vision which is like way too, you know, beyond. Like I'm pretty much sure that he has plans for like 10 years from now, 20 years from now, I will be doing this, that. So he's a very visionary person, and I have a lot of respect for the work that he is doing and the way he articulates himself. Now, that being said, I'll give my opinion about how, you know, I felt the entire vibe. I have the Meta app downloaded in my phone right now, in my tab as well. So completely. So this is not you, me ranting or me hating over Varun. That's not what this is. What I'm talking about is that, a lot of time there is a difference between what we speak and what is interpreted by the audience. And I think Tanmay Bhatt had a very nice segment about this topic in one of his podcasts, wherein he was explaining the exact difference, what it happens like when we say something and how the audience interprets it. Now, this is a thing which I've observed a lot about the Avalon Army in general. Now, not, you know, brushing it over everyone. There might be, you know, students who might be way too talented also. But this is what I felt as a student being a part of the Avalon Army community. When Varun Maya says that, oh, you know, colleges are useless, colleges are worthless, and you need to learn skills and you need to implement those skills. Varun as a piece of talent is way exceptional as a human. Just forget about Varun Maya, the influencer, the YouTuber, or the founder of Avalon. Just take him as an individual human. He's way too talented than the average human you find out. Like if you read his Instagram bio, raised money from VC funds at the age of 20. Now, 20. That is not something which you see an average 20-year-old doing. Again, now talking about his current skill sets, forget about 20. Let's talk about what he's doing right now. I know like a lot of people, and everyone has told me that everyone has their own sectors. Like if a guy is good in tech, he's good in coding. He's good in all the tech related stuff. If a guy is good in designing, he's good in his photo editing, video editing, and all his design related stuff. If someone is good in commerce, then he's good in, you know, stock market and trading and all of that stuff.
Yep.
Varun Maya as an individual is like a tank in himself. Like as an individual, he's good in all of this, which is once again, not what you see in the average individual. And here's where my problem comes. When Varun Maya says that, you know, colleges are bad and, you know, you don't need colleges to succeed in your life and you'll just learn skills online and you'll be good to go. He is comparing it based on the talents that he has. Now, not blaming this on him, but this is a problem among Indian audiences in general, that Indian audiences mirror the thoughts of the creators they follow. Like, so if today I back to back for 1 week, I consume only Varun Maya content. 8th day, I will also wake up saying that, okay, I'm dialing to my college and saying, okay, remove my admission. I'll be that level of a guy. Now, the problem with that is that when you mirror the thoughts of your creators, you only kind of say the things that he's saying, or, you know, you only think in the way that he's thinking, but that does not mean that you get the talent or you get the skill set that the other person possesses. Now, here's my take. Concluding my entire storyline, which I formed, Varun as a person is so talented that even if today you pull away all his assets, he will start from scratch and he will get his basics in sort. He won't, you know, be begging for money, obviously. He will get his basics sorted and he will keep himself and his family in a very good environment. Not something which almost an average Indian will be able to do. For an average student who is, let's say, mirroring his thoughts and who is saying that, okay, no respect for college, I will learn courses and I will get a high-paying job, I don't think that the average member of the Avalon Army will be able to do so. Now, yes, the Avalon Army gets placements, gets huge placements, but I don't think that's like 5% or 10% of the crowd. I don't think that every individual in that, and that's my only argument against Varun, that, you know, when you say things like college is not needed and skills will take you somewhere, yes, skills will take you somewhere. Like you as an individual, Varun Maya, you have the skills. You know literally everything from tech to cold calling, cold emailing, reaching out to recruiters and getting the jobs. You will be pretty much sorted in your life. But for a 20-year-old, 22-year-old listening to it, maybe he does not have that level of a skill set and still he's mirroring your thoughts. So for everyone, for any, like if Varun is listening to this, he might have probably got my point. But for any student who is a part of the Avalon Army and listening to this, my only thing is that first develop yourself. So I was having this conversation with one of my friends and I just told him one line which summarizes my entire story till today. I told him, jis din main Varun Maya jitna talented ban jaunga na, us din main bhi college ko gaali dunga. Tab tak I don't have the right to do that. कि मेरे पास उस बंदे जितना टैलेंट भी नहीं है और मैं गालियां भी दे रहा हूँ, तो मैं किसी कहीं का नहीं रहा, ना मैं यहाँ का रहा, ना मैं वहां का रहा, ना मैं तुम्हारा जनरल जो जॉब्स मिलती मैं उसमें भी अप्लाई नहीं कर पाऊंगा, मैं साइड प्रोफेशन भी मेरा ढंग से नहीं चलेगा, फिर धोबी का कुत्ता टाइप सीन्स हो जाएगा. So that is the point which I have to make, and like now you can go about your entire, because I know you know about Varun and I know that you follow him.
Yes, I do follow him and I watch his Instagram stories in live also. He's a very creative and very intelligent person who knows many, many things. So I call these kind of person as a specialist in generalist. So they are the generalist, they know everything, but they are special in that thing. And I have seen Varun in that domain. But somewhere I feel this is a bold game of against self-awareness, I believe. Because if a person knows like what they want to do, so I tell you, a person is a successful if he or she does his or her MBA from Harvard and then getting placed to Facebook and then earning lakhs of rupees. And if he or she is happy, then she won the game. And if a person, and if she is meant for a business and she is meant for an, if she is an entrepreneur and still she is going for an MBA, then working in Facebook, then she might be not happy. So it's depend on us. Like if you believe that I am a freelancer kind of a thing and I want to start on my own, so that might be Varun is right that you don't need a college degree. But if some people are happy to spend a quality time with their family after coming at 6, they want to drink a tea with their wife or they want to drink the tea with their husband working in a big corporate, and they don't want to take attention or they don't want to take extra burden. So there are different kinds of people. So one want to learn him or herself, like what kind of person I am. If I am that kind of a person who wants to do different things and different risk-taking abilities I have, then I don't think college will give those kind of things to you. So in that case, Varun is right totally. But as you said, like everyone cannot be an entrepreneur. So there has to be an employee. And employees doesn't mean they will not start something in their future. So if they choose a path of a college and then they work in some companies for 5 or 10 years, then they think like, now I want to do a business, then it's totally their choice. And while moving into entrepreneurship and doing a freelancing work, again, the self-awareness part comes about their family, about their financial part. So this is where I have been in that position. Like I always wanted to do a business. But I was not able to take those kind of risk, financial risk. So I chose a safe and secure path to go to the MBA, then take a job and first develop my financials. And then I will come to the field. So these kind of totally two things are going. And I totally agree, like people in the Avalon Army, because they are the age of 20 or less than 25. So they will listen to these things and they will really get pumped. Like I want to just leave my job right now or leave my college right now and I want to do some freelancing kind of. But as you said, like everyone is not worm. And I totally believe like these two things are right. Everyone has its pros and cons. So it's a game of self-awareness. And I totally understand like at the age of 25, no one knows properly. Like they are not self-aware, even not me either. So it's totally a game of exploration. And when you do exploration, you need to take risk. And when you take risk, you need to see like who are the people who are behind you. If your family members are 3 to 4 family members and no one is earning properly, then I don't think it's a good move to take such kind of a risk. That's my point of view.
Even if we take the risk topic, you know, even if we consider that, okay, maybe their family is earning enough, an individual's family is earning enough, if he has to take care only about himself, I'm still saying that, you know, compare yourself to Varun. If you can actually say that, okay, I'm also as talented as him, then you get the eligibility to say that, okay, college is, I don't care about college and, you know, I don't need college to be successful in life. But only and only when you are 100% confident ke main Varun Maya jitna talented hu, jo 99% log nahi hai. And that's where the problem is. You know, when they say, a very simple thing, let's just change the conversation so that it will get a little more contextual. If you look at your favorite hero heroine and you say that, okay, this particular set of clothes that he's wearing looks very cool on him. Perfect. If you take that exact same clothes and wear, probably you won't look you won't look the way that person is looking. Why? Because those clothes are like tailor-made according to his body design, his body shape and all. Exactly that same clothes won't look good on you. So you need to take the design from that person and then tailor make it according to your measurements. And that's what a lot of people I have noticed fail to do. So they are like, okay, Varun Maya says colleges are bad. Varun Maya says that you can learn skills and be successful in life. Take the exact same model, implement in your life. But no, you aren't the same human being. He has way too many skill sets than an average individual will have. So obviously that is something which I wanted to put out.
Yeah. So Morris, you are right actually, but somewhere I feel that it is not just Varun is intelligent. Yes, Varun is, but the people in the Avalon army, there might be people like talented like him also, or they can be molded into that shape. Because when you told the example of clothing about the actor or actress, so see, there are always a role model for you. And there should be a role model for you. Like, so if I have a role model like Hrithik Roshan or Tiger Shroff because of their body, like their physique, so one day I will think like, I want to be that kind of a person. So I will work hard in that direction. So if people are keeping a role model to Varun, then they should understand that you can keep that kind of capability to be that kind of person. So from the initial thought only, if we think like, I am not like a Varun, so I will do a normal MBA or normal post-graduation and do the job, then that is also not a right thing.
Both extremes are wrong. You need to be self-aware in the fact that, okay, do I want to be like Varun, and B, am I capable enough? Because there are people, genetics is a thing. Okay, some people are born with, you know, sheer talent. Okay, so am I that in good? And in your college, you actually have time to figure out things, so you can actually, you know, try that. Okay, let's follow Varun Maya. Let's see, try to do the things that he's doing. He works on multiple softwares. First, learn all of them. And if you see, if you can actually do all the things that he is currently doing, then say that, okay, bye-bye college. I'm following him currently.
Yes. And what happens, like, sometimes when you don't do certain kind of things, like if you drop the college and if you do choose the path of freelancing or do certain kind of skill set and follow Varun Maya's path of exploring new things without degree. But what happens in that course, people fail when they compare themselves with the people who are doing the job and working in the corporate. So this shouldn't be happening. So they think like, this guy is working in that company, his life is so sorted and I have left the college. No, it is not like that. If you are leaving the college, then I mean, there should be all in about
own up to your decisions.
Own up to a decision. Like, you took this decision, then leave up to the mark. Whatever hardship you are facing, if you're not earning for like 6 months, that's fine. I mean, you can work on those things only. Do it, give it a try for more 6 months. And I mean, consult Varun Maya again and see whatever things I am lagging behind. So, and last, if he is thinking like, no, I'm not getting that kind of a skill set like Varun has, then again, he or she can choose the same path like whatever other people are choosing. But people are getting very much depressed after this thing. When they fail to do something. I've seen many people who do CA and they do one attempt or two attempt and their whole life is like a depression. Like we were not able to crack in one attempt, and people with me in same school and same people who are studying in my fifth standard and they have cleared this thing. Everyone is different. It's just about the self-awareness game and it comes with the exploration only.
Yeah, true. So, and I don't know the probabilities of this happening, but in any way, if this video reaches Varun Maya, I would love to have a conversation with him about his entire, because I'm sure that if he has watched this video till the end, he will have certain counter arguments that, okay, you said this, yes, but here's my perspective to this. Here's my perspective to that. So if he does, I'd love to have a conversation with him on this topic. So yeah.